Good morning, South Plainfield. Today is Wednesday, February 22nd, 2023. I'm Shannon O'Flaherty.
And I'm Emma Ballinger, and you're watching Tiger TV.
Attention juniors, the Fudge fundraiser is on. If you're interested in selling, please stop by room 560 to pick up the form or print the attachment. The forms are due by March 20th. Money needs to be collected at the time of the order. Checks need to be made out to SPHS class of 2023. Please see Ms. Klett or Spo in room 560 if you have any questions. Of course it's Spo.
Oh God.
Of course it's Spo. Silly guy.
Funniest guy I know.
I want Fudge now. The High School Drama Club will be hosting a fundraiser at Boss Hog after school on Friday from 3 to 7. Dine in or take food to go, and 15% of the profits will go towards the drama club. Come stop by and support us for this year's musical, The Wedding Singer. The South Plainfield Music Department is holding a coffee house fundraiser tonight from 6 to 8 p.m. in the High School Info Center. This will feature solo and small ensemble acts by our very talented music students. The SPHS Jazz Ensemble will also be performing a few selections. Admissions is $5 suggested donation at the door, and coffee and baked goods will be available for purchase. Please come out and support our students and enjoy some great music. We can't wait to see you there. If you thought the UFO news was just starting to die down, now an artificial intelligence program from the University of Toronto has picked up 8 mysterious radio signals that could be coming from aliens. The signals were sourced to the area surrounding stars 30 light years away. It's Jake Shapiro.
What?
Do you know about the 7 continents? How about the continent full of ice, Antarctica? Many can argue that Antarctica is the most affected when it comes to climate crisis, and we will go over why people think that. If you walk out your front door and really observe the world, climate change is everywhere. Starting its defrosting state over the past 50 years, global warming is causing Antarctica to melt its ice shells faster each year. Statistics show that between 1992 to 2017, there was a loss of about 2,700 gigatons of ice that melted. If Antarctica's ice were to entirely melt, the sea level would rise by about 200 feet. Treaties have been built, such as the Antarctic and Southern Ocean Coalition, that work together to protect Antarctica and its surrounding oceans from environmental damages. There is also a risk of extinction for emperor penguins due to the changes in their lifestyle, like their breeding patterns and food cycles. There are approximately 595,000 adult emperor penguins in Antarctica right now. And finally, policies are being created that protect krill from being captured by fishers to reduce the number of losses with emperor penguins, since krill is their main food source.
But as an upside to this disastrous situation, scientists are now able to determine what is really under the layer of ice that is about 4,700 meters thick. Due to all the years studying Antarctica carefully, it is learned in school that global warming's main cause is the extensive use of fossil fuels that create a heat-trapping layer of gas that is in our ozone layer, for example, carbon dioxide. The best way we can help Antarctica is with little things, from reducing energy consumption, recycling, using efficient transportation, and even letting your voice be heard can have an impact if everyone works together. Global warming is affecting every inch of the Earth, from the south to the North Pole. There's no denying it. There are theories that go around with a possible new ice age, or the hotter it gets in summer and the cooler it gets in winter. But global warming is happening, and the only way to help our planet is with taking that first step towards the right direction and start to change our ways for the better.
Attention seniors, Middlesex College will be coming to SPHS on March 16th for an instant decision day. This means you will meet with a representative from Middlesex College and get told instantly if you are accepted. If you're interested, please sign up in guidance ASAP. President Joe Biden made a surprising appearance in Kiev on Monday to show solidarity and mark the one-year anniversary of the war in Ukraine. The president traveled by plane and then train for over 10 hours in secrecy to reach the war-torn capital. On Tuesday, he spoke to a crowd of thousands in Warsaw, Poland, pledging unwavering support for the embattled nation. The war has claimed the lives of over 8,000 Ukrainian civilians and an estimated 200,000 Russian soldiers. The American Dream Mall, DreamWorks Water Park, will remain closed indefinitely while the state reviews an incident that injured four people over the weekend. A large decorative helicopter fell from the ceiling into a swimming pool below while people were in the water just after 3 p.m. on Sunday. The New Jersey Department of Community Affairs has ordered the park to stay closed pending review of the incident. The Six Flags guy could not be reached for a comment. Shannon, college survey time.
The survey is still up. The QR code will be here again. Here's some results. You're fine. Your finger, completely fine. There'll be some, here's some results. I think Temple's winning right now. You can vote, take a vote. The QR code is still here. That's it for today's announcements.
Have a great day, Steph.
And stop voting for NYU. I'm not getting in. Stop.
Ohio State? Done.
I took it off the survey.
Thank God.
The moment I got rejected.
Thank God.